You were thought about for months before we even knew who you were. And hours and hours were spent not only commuting back and forth from Britain, but Chicago, telephone calls lasted 2-3 hours trying to put this thing together. And really the intellectual father of what we put together here has joined us tonight. My best friend, please welcome Andy Anuzis.
Well, thanks for having me here today. I wanted to begin by just complimenting Stephanie on her report of what she saw at the Kurt Center at Friday Health. Just like you, over 20 years ago, I got to go to Friday Health as well. And I met Russell Kurt and Annette Kurt, and I got to learn from him. And I found it every bit as inspirational as you did. And I hope that all of you will, you know, take the opportunities that Randall's giving you to really go deeper and learn more. And the whole idea here was to learn from the best people that are out there available to teach us. So I compliment you and encourage you all to take some of those opportunities. Let me begin by perhaps sharing with you the question that we posed earlier today about what is your mission in life. For a living, I'm Chief of Staff to Congressman Thaddeus McCotter. I work in Washington, D.C. It's an exciting job. I believe in my boss, the chairman of the House Policy Committee. He's charged with the important task of putting together the big picture vision of where the Republican Party needs to go to restore itself, to make its case to the American people in a way that's compelling, that they'll buy into us again. It's a big task. I love my boss and I respect him. My real passion in life, though, my vision is the new Centurion Program. I checked with my emails. We started conversing about this back, not this February, but the February before. And one of the things that we thought about early on was what we wanted to see this thing become. We want this to be a national movement, that in all 50 states, people get together in places like Detroit, Lansing, and Grand Rapids, and begin a conservative resurgence from the bottom up. A couple things motivated me. I'm sure. The first thing was, I read a book called The Gift of Freedom. It's written by John Miller, who is the editor of National Review Magazine. And he talked about how all the big foundation money is pumping money into big places like Harvard and Stanford, the Heritage Foundation, to capture the commanding wing of the intellectual movement. And I thought, what about people like me, and what about people like Randall? And what about folks in this room who are actually out on the front lines trying to change their communities? Why don't we have a foundational presence for us? And I said, if it's not out there, we need to start building it. Let me tell you what else gave me a little bit of a kick in the pants. You might be surprised by this, but it was Ann Coulter. I'm watching Ann Coulter ridiculing and making fun of John Edwards on television. And I thought, you know, this is what the American people see when they think about conservatism. They see kind of an angry, elbows up, insulting kind of conservatism. That's not the conservatism that I was brought up. I said, we need to get deep with this again. Bring back to some ideas that are positive and affirming. That's really what got me off the couch and getting with Randall and starting to build this thing again. But it was to build a national movement. And there's just one thing that I wanted to share with you today as an encouragement to you. And that's the idea of building community and building partnerships. On my way over here, love coming back to Detroit because I was listening to WRIF because I miss it. And then I turned the key just a little bit and listened to some NPR to do the evening news, right?
Ooh.
Yeah, that's right. Just check it out a little bit. But it gave me my thought that I was looking for tonight, and that was this idea of partnerships and community. Focus Hope was started right after the Detroit riots by a Lithuanian and an Irishman, Sister Jositis and Father Cunningham. And what they did, let's face it, back in the 1960s, all that social upheaval. I'm guessing that these two liberal Catholic activists, you know, were not where we're at politically. I don't think Eleanor Jositis was a Goldwater girl, you know. But look what they did. They built, in a community, an organization that brought about self-sufficiency. They brought about a program that teaches people to work, learn, and they taught thousands of people how to work their way up from poverty. And here's what she shared. She said, you know, for me it was the three P's. It was passion, persistence, and partnerships. So let me share with you a little bit about our partnership. Randall and I worked on this thing to build it together. And he is such a fantastic presenter, so energetic and charismatic and intelligent. I don't think this program would have worked without him. Later in this process, we brought in Darren Moore, right? You guys know Darren. He came in, he literally came in. You know, Darren comes in, you can hear, you know, George Thorogood's bat to the bone, you know, pumping out of the speakers, right? But we needed that. We needed that passion. We needed that drive. We needed that persuasion. We needed that salesmanship. And that's what I want to encourage all of you to think about today. What is the partnership and the community that you're going to come out of this, this program with? If you want to have a vision and a mission that's compelling and that works, you've got to have a group of people that can work as a team and make it happen. So today was about mission, but I want you guys to think also partnership. Who can I partner with in this room and outside that will really help me get my mission put together? Let me make a pledge to you. From the very beginning, part of our idea was to say, after you've gone through your 12-month program, we're not going to forgive you. We're going to invest in you. I had a meeting with Mike Chander, Noah. And I'm going to ask for your help here a little bit, Greg. What company did he use to run a Fortune 500? I think it was Perigo.
Yes.
Fortune 500 CEO, made a lot of money, left it. Now he's making investments in Grand Rapids, real community leader. And we asked him, I said, would you come and meet with our best and brightest new Centurions and really spend meaningful time with them, teaching what you know? Sure. We've talked to U.S. Congressman, so would you come and meet our Centurions on an intimate basis and sit down for a couple of hours and really get to know them and let them down the road with you? Sure. People like Lee Whitney and Annette Kirk and others are willing to invest time with you because of the investment that you've made in here. So the partnership's going to keep going for you. So I would just encourage you tonight to really keep that in mind. What's going to be my partnership? What's going to be my team to pull me in the right direction? Let me just move on tonight and introduce our main speaker. And his name is Greg McNeely. Larry Lee, who's running for prosecutor, and I, and Greg were sitting back there talking about all the times. In 1986, we worked on the campaigns. I was a state director. Larry was one of our Oakland County leaders. Greg was an intern at the Robertson campaign, but we all got together back then. And since then, Greg McNeely has really made a name for himself in Michigan politics. I'll bet you, if you went around and asked people who ran for governor, Senate, Senate Majority Leader, that kind of thing, you say, okay, it's crisis mode. You're in deep trouble. You get to choose four people to be in the room with you to solve the problem. If you grab the top 10 Republican politicians in the state, so give me a list of four people you want in the room, I guarantee you almost every one of those 10 would have Greg McNeely's name on that list. He was campaign manager for Dick DeVos. He was the executive director of the Michigan Republican Party. He spent a lot of time laboring in the vineyards and being a leader in the school choice movement, working for Kids First Yes. Now he's a nationally renowned political consultant. And keeping in the spirit of our new Centurion program, we're going to bring you the best speakers in the state, Greg McNeely.